Hello guys, this is CRG.
Turn up the game.
Guys, this is a very expected episode. It's time for the Lightning versus the Bulldozer.
Who is the best in score match?
Let's see. You all know, if you want to cross in score match, you need to use one of these two formations. Which are those, Modest?
3-5-2 and 5-3-2. This is why we are going to use 5-3-2 here in order to see the behavior of this new golden player against Matsumoto, the Bulldozer.
Or against the Hammers. Yeah. I have three Hammers in defense while Madeline has two Hammers and a Bulldozer.
Exactly.
We have both the Lightning in attack, while next to him I have a Prowler. You have what?
I have the Gatecrasher.
The Gatecrasher.
Yeah, I am trying to pass the ball.
Okay, you know what? Lightning
Gatecrasher.
First of the ball against, who's there? A Hammer.
Check.
A Hammer level 9 took away the ball from the Lightning. I mean, on the ground, not in the air. What I want to see is the duel in the air.
Exactly.
But I will let you now try to cross, Madeline. Maybe you will switch sides here to the Wizard on the other side.
Yes, I'm going to do this through my Protector.
Just let me know when you will pass to him.
First of all, I have to find the perfect.
Perfect.
The engine was better positioned there.
But now I will. It's my chance to try an attack. I will lose some time here until my players get into position. I will pass it to my tailor. We are pros already in playing volleyball and crossing games. No, just regular people. Okay, engine, passing it to the wizard, and maybe I will get a chance now to switch sides. Or, I see my... unfortunately, my Lightning is not going into the right direction. But maybe now, a little bit of time on the right flank. And yes, now I can pass it to the marksman. I think, Madeline, you're not defending, right?
No,
the opportunity to cross.
Yeah.
And now the marksman will have a chance to pass it to Abubakar. And that's the first cross against the Hammer. Winner, Hammer level 9. Again, Hammer dominated Abubakar. Maybe because of the strength, Madeline. Because even though they have the same speed, height, 40.
Yeah.
The speed, the strength is fairly... it's very... very small for the Lightning, while very big for the Hammers.
Yeah, also a big difference between them is the response, which is less for the Lightning. But anyhow, in these conditions, we expect to have a more balanced battle between these two players.
Otherwise, the Lightning will win everything. And let's see now, Lightning versus Hammer on the ground. He's first to the ball. But why was this an advantage?
I think that was an offside.
It was an offside?
This is why,
I don't think so, but maybe. Okay, now... maybe I will try to pass it to the marksman a little bit, but the marksman is still here. Okay, you know what? That's gonna be a cross by my Jebe, by the Prowler. Let's see.
The Prowler. It was an offside there.
Jebe, what are you doing?
On the line.
On the line. But you should know the thing that the Bulldozer played really fine at offside.
Now I'm going to change my side from my Hammer to my Engine, from my Engine to my Hammer. From the first touch to my marksman, and let's see, advanced, go ahead and pass it to my Lightning, who is trying, as always, to, let's see...
The Hammer dominated him, he fell, in the duel he fell, and now, on the ground, again, a chance for Lightning. You see, on the ground, his speed compensates a lot, but unfortunately for him, on the ground, in the air, as I said, he's not good at all.
Yes, he's not reliable.
Madeline, look at this.
Yeah. From the wizard. Whoa!
I tried to blow it.
It's very close. Yeah, with the wizard, it's very easy to score.
Floaters.
Yeah, but let's see now. I'm going again to try to build a cross from
side. I honestly think that even the protectors and the guards will beat Abubakar in the air.
Yeah.
So now you ask me, why is he tall? And I'm gonna give you a good answer, Madeline.
Why he's tall?
You cross it to him now?
No.
Okay. You're playing really poorly today,
Madeline. I know. I was trying.
Hopefully, in the second game you will play better, because in the second game I have a surprise for you.
Whoa.
For you all.
Okay. Let's see.
And I'm gonna answer the question, why is he tall? Okay. Let's see if he now gets first to the ball. He gets first to the ball next to the Hammer, and that's an amazing goal in the last second of the game with Abubakar. Let's switch things a little bit and go back to the second game. Now, Madeline, it's time for my answer. Why is he tall, ladies and gentlemen? The reason why he's tall is because he's the perfect wingman. He is perfect as a right wing or a left wing, and you will see in this game, because I changed my formation. Look at the keeper, what is he doing there? So I changed my formation to 4-2-1-3, and I'm playing him on the right side. He will be marked by the marksman. He will be marked by the marksman, and I think he will be better at headers than the marksman. I just need the ball, and you will see how good he really is in the air on the wing. But Madalene is trying to prove me wrong here. He's trying to prove me that he didn't play bad in the first game, and I'm still using hammers and stuff.
Let's see now a cross from my marksman to the lightning, who will not win the duel against the hammer in the air.
He cannot win the duel against the hammer in the air. The hammer is far better than him in the air.
This is why we mentioned also in the previous episode that the lightning is not going to be a good player in the volleyball. This is why you need to use him as a winger, as Cosmin is using right now.
He may be good in volleyball, but not as a solo strike. I mean, not as the main, let's say, target for crossings.
Mm-hmm.
He must be played as something else. But look at this example. Prowler next to Bulldozer, with his response, he gets first of the ball and passes the ball. That's the reason why he's not... I mean, Abubakar is not as reliable in the air, but... as a central striker, sorry. And the invader here, because of his worst response, didn't get the ball here in front of the hammer.
Also, what we need to have in mind is that with his running ability, he's not going to wait for you in order to send the cross into the box. He will try to support the midfielders in order to build the attack.
Look at this one. Now lightning in the air. Unfortunately, invader was faster
than
him. But that's not how you play wingers. You will see. If I get the ball to my invader will send the ball back to Abubakar, and that's going to be a great chance. And now Abubakar floats. Oh, I tried the floater.
So close.
With floaters, it's a little bit tough, because you need to not draw the line as you usually do in a shot. And I did exactly that. That's the reason why my goal, that was the goal. Okay, tell me when you pass it to him.
Okay, meanwhile, as always, I'll try to send the ball to my wingers,
now,
and now I will pass it to him.
I will choose my
from my wizard
hammer
to him, and
absolutely
again.
No chance. He doesn't
it's
even
impossible.
Jump.
Yeah.
He doesn't even jump. But now I will show you, I think, I hope. If my prowler will decide to pass the ball to the invader.
No, he will not. He'll try to go alone, but now he'll try to pass it back, because...
Unbelievable.
My protector was very close to take the ball from him. This is why he decided to pass.
Unbelievable.
Such a
and now does
player.
He have a chance because of his speed? Oh
now he's taking the ball. He would try to score from there, but it was blocked.
It was blocked. However, once I get the ball to my invader, I really hope I'll get the ball to my invader, he will cross it on the other side of the lightning, and from there I promise you that lightning will be first to the ball. And that's how you make use of his height. But not to fight the
chance
hammers.
From my side with this header.
He has absolutely
no
chance. So he's rubbish against tall defenders. He's rubbish.
Yeah.
And as I said, I think he's rubbish also against protectors, to be honest. We can try that. We can try that in another episode. But I strongly believe he is rubbish. Okay, from Sierra to the hammer. Please, somebody pass it to my invader on the left side, please.
Mm-hmm.
I need
he's
the ball.
Trying to do it right
now. I will pass it to the hammer here.
Mm-hmm.
And hammer, where is the invader? The invader is a main striker now.
Yes.
Running ability, guys.
From a defender to a main striker.
I will hope. I will send the ball a little bit on the sides, and now that's a chance. Invader. Okay. Two lightning. As a winger.
Because I have an
invader
there.
But
exactly.
What's the difference between the response of the invader and the response of the invader has a bigger response, right?
Yes, 15 units more, I think.
15? Okay.
Yes.
Okay,
yes,
now cross it to him
again.
Please, last chance against a tall defender.
From my protector
will
to
do,
him,
no.
The same.
Don't cross it to him,
yeah.
He's bad in the air. Shootout, nobody cares about it.
Yes.
This was the end of the episode, I think, ladies and gentlemen. Myth busted. He is rubbish against tall defenders, against hammers, against bulldozers.
Yep.
In another episode, maybe in a regular episode, we will do a fight between him and maybe a protector or a guard. On paper, it should... What are you saving my penalties?
I'm winning. I'm trying to win. So, we will try to focus and also on the ground, not only on the headers.
But on the ground, we all know he's really good. But on the headers, I mean, he's tall. He should be good at headers, but he's not.
I think the main... the strength and also the positioning is very important if you are trying to send the cross into the box.
Correct.
For the lightning.
This was the end of the episode. This is Abubakar again. He is really, really, really good as a winger, but he's very bad as playing the ball with the head. This was the end of the episode. I hope you enjoyed it.
Yeah, don't forget to leave a like, a comment, and a share. Subscribe to our YouTube channel in order to not miss the future episodes. And until next time, play Score Match. See you.
Bye.
Bye.